Greetings, friends. David Marks here. If you've followed my videos for many years, then you've heard me talk about the need for a robust image backup system. I harp on this topic again and again because accidents happen and because Adobe offers no advice on this critical topic for classic users. In my experience, I've seen two outcomes when things go terribly wrong. For those with a good backup system in place, a hard drive failure is an inconvenience. Nobody is happy when their drive failed, but if you're prepared, then this is not the end of the world. Unfortunately, for those who are not properly prepared, drive failure can result in catastrophic data loss. In some of my other tutorials, I've explained how to back up all of your photos using external hard drives. Today, I want to show you how to create an online backup using a cloud backup service called Backblaze. Before we get started, I need to make a few things clear. First, an online backup service is no substitute for the backups that I keep on hand in my own home. Second, in the interest of full disclosure, I must admit that I am a Backblaze affiliate. If you sign up for their service using one of the links around this video, then they'll send me a small commission. I am not sponsored by this company. I chose to talk about their service today because this is something that I actually use and I pay them each month for my online backup needs. With those warnings out of the way, let's jump in and let's get started. Before I turned on the microphone today, I went to Backblaze.com and downloaded their personal backup software. I'm going to demonstrate on a Mac today, but Backblaze offers an almost identical program for you PC users, and they have a free trial that anyone can use to try things out. After I downloaded their product, I installed their software on my computer, and then I granted it permission to access files on my internal and external hard drives. When the installation was complete, their backup manager began to scan my computer's internal drive and to look for the files that it needs to back up. The factory default installation worked just fine, but what the program doesn't know is that I'm particularly interested in using it to back up all of my photography and my Adobe Photoshop Lightroom catalog. To tell Backblaze about these essential elements, I'm going to tap here on the Pause Backup button, and then I'm going to tap here where it says Settings. If you are using an external hard drive or multiple external hard drives for your primary image storage, then we need to tell Backblaze to include the files that live on those drives within our backup set. Your image storage system and mine may differ, but if I open up Adobe Photoshop Lightroom Classic right now, then you can see that these images are not on my computer's internal hard drive. Most of the photos that my catalog indexes live here in this Photos Go In Here folder. The point that I'm trying to emphasize is that if this external hard drive is not included in my Backblaze backup, then I'm wasting my money here and I'm failing to protect my most precious assets. So, for me, that means including this 1 terabyte SanDisk external. And to do that, I need to put a little check mark right here. Including that external hard drive is the most essential step in the setup process. And now, my backup can chug along for the days or months that it's going to take to upload all of my photos. Since I know that uploading all of my photos is going to be a very slow process, I'm also going to change one more thing. Since my internet is not the world's fastest, I'm going to tap here where it says Schedule, and then I'm going to change these settings so that my computer will only upload files for me from about 10 p.m. to 8 a.m. If you have a strong unlimited internet connection, then this step is not necessary, but restricting the backup hours helps someone like me, someone with an average home connection. Along those lines, I'm also going to adjust my computer's power consumption settings. And I'm going to tell my computer at least for the next few months, while it's uploading things, that I don't want it to sleep automatically when the display is turned off. With things set this way, my computer will stay awake all night and Backblaze can upload while nothing else is going on. Now, if you're an advanced user, then there are some other settings in here that you might want to adjust. For those who are worried, setting a private encryption key will add more security into your backups. But for most of us, I think things are good at this point, so I'm going to hit OK. There is one more important detail that I need to mention. If you are like me, then you really need to understand the way that Backblaze deals with files that live on external disks. Once Backblaze uploads a copy of a file, let's say one of my photographs for the purpose of this discussion, then it continues to check on that file every time that my backup set gets updated. As long as image 123 is still on my hard drive, then a perfect copy of that file should remain online within my backup set. If I change something about image 123, let's say I apply new develop settings to it in Lightroom, then that info, my new settings, those will automatically get uploaded for me when Backblaze next runs. And if I were to delete this file, then Backblaze will automatically trash the copy that they have on their servers after 30 days. Under ordinary circumstances, this 30-day version history is no problem. But if you have files on an external hard drive, and if you do not connect that external drive for more than 30 days, then Backblaze will assume that all of those files no longer exist, and it will delete those files from their server. Now, they're not trying to be jerks here. The Backblaze company will send you email after email warning you that your files are scheduled for deletion unless you connect that external hard drive again and give their software a chance to update your backup. For most people, this 30-day clock poses no risk. But if you store important files on an external hard drive, and if you rarely plug that drive in, then this could be a big problem. If you think that you're going to find yourself in this position, if you want Backblaze to store a copy of your files for more than 30 days, no matter what, then you can click here where it says Version History Upgrade and pay Backblaze a little bit more each month for a longer data retention period. If this rare scenario applies to you, then be sure to click on this button and investigate the additional options. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you learned something today, then please hit the subscribe button and leave us a like or a comment down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.